Einstein has been exclusively portrayed as the father of relativity, both special and general, by many people, as if that were his only contribution to modern physics. But that is untrue. In fact, Einstein had been the most important theoretical physicist for understanding the quanta of thermal radiation, known as photons, and its coexistence with matter, long before quantum mechanics was established. Today, I'm going to report my latest revelation of Einstein's two contrasting responses to the earliest papers on quantum statistics by Bose in 1924, which seems barely known. Welcome to Jung Tuition. I am Jung. Are you ready? Let's go and have fun. In June 1924, before Heisenberg and Schrodinger's quantum theories were unified by Dirac, Einstein received a letter from a stranger in India, together with a manuscript in English. "Respected sir, if you think the paper worth publication, I shall be grateful if you arrange for the publication." Bose was 30 years old then. His paper was entitled "Planck's Law and the Light Quantum Hypothesis." What Bose proposed is the first derivation of the Planck's Law without using any classical electromagnetic wave theory, unlike what all previous researchers had done, including Einstein. In essence, Bose introduced his new way to count the number of the possible arrangement of photons given quantum states. That eventually became the Bose-Einstein statistics for any bosons with integer spin, including Higgs particles. Einstein was amazed and delighted. Why? Because he had made a number of attempts in searching for a deeper interpretation of the Planck's law for blackbody radiation in the past 20 years. Bose's new idea and mathematical treatment provided a new insight at last. Einstein immediately translated the paper into German and sent to a leading journal for publication with the following comments: "Bose's derivation of Planck's formula appears to me to be an important step forward." Bose was very happy and even overwhelmed by Einstein's prompt response. In fact, Bose had more big ideas in his mind, in particular, how to use statistics to describe the thermal equilibrium between radiation and matter beyond the Planck's law. So he immediately wrote his second paper entitled "Thermal Equilibrium in the Radiation Field and in the Presence of Matter," in which Bose introduced a product of two numbers as shown here. One is the possible ways photon in quantum state can be arranged. Another possible way molecules can be arranged given different energy levels. Why did Bose do that? Because the product is related to the entropy based on Boltzmann's formula, S equal to K natural log W. That was how Boltzmann and himself derived their thermal equilibrium distribution laws for molecules and photons, respectively. By maximizing the product, Bose shown that his early quantum statistics for photons can be extended for both photons and molecules that are at a thermal equilibrium. In July, he sent his second paper to Einstein, expecting similar outcomes. Guess what happened? Without carefully evaluating Bose's new proposal, Einstein categorically claimed, "I believe Bose's hypothesis concerning elementary radiation processes to be invalid." How come? In 1916, in light of the Bohr's atomic theory, Einstein proposed a new method to inversely derive the Planck's law by invoking two energy levels for gas molecules to describe the interactions between radiation and matter. Einstein argued that gas molecules can jump up to the higher energy level by absorbing a photon. The process is called absorption. Also, gas molecules can return to the ground level by emitting a photon, either spontaneously or induced by the radiation field, or both. The process is called emission. However, Bose shown that Einstein's induced emission is unnecessary in his new theory. Although this seems trivial compared with Bose's main ideas and new results in his second paper, Einstein was in his defensive mode for his early ideas and ego this time. It was said that Bose sent his third paper to Einstein to further explain his point, but no reply from Einstein. As a result, Bose didn't keep his third paper and abandoned his basic research on radiation and matter, as he admired Einstein profoundly. If you know how laser works, you might think Einstein was right about his stimulated emission, another term for induced emission, because laser refers to light amplification by stimulated emission radiation. Nevertheless, stimulated emission between two energy levels is a transient, subject to the relaxation time and how to measure it. I know this issue well as I investigated so-called adiabatic rapid passage in my PhD project, where randomly rotating molecules such as proteins can partially diminish the negative absorption, another term for induced emission. This is my paper published in 1992. In fact, sustainable or continuous stimulated emission was first realized in three energy level systems of condensed matter in microwave range, known as MESER, M for microwave, due to the work by Blombergen, one of the real heroes in magnetic resonance and non-linear optics. By and large, interactions between radiation and matter are far more complicated than what Einstein and Bose had thought in their statistical descriptions for many indistinguishable particles. For this reason, perhaps, Einstein stopped his research on radiation and matter around 1927 when quantum mechanics for single particle was established. In summary, Bose first proposed his quantum statistics a few years before quantum mechanics was established. Einstein was very happy for Bose's first paper and helped Bose to publish in German. But then Einstein couldn't stand for Bose's criticism on his induced emission or stimulated emission. More interesting story about our understanding of radiation and matter will be told on this channel based on my independent research since 1980s. Thank you for watching. Thank you for making comments. See you next time.